Thailand confirms another monkeypox case. The third case is a 25-year-old German tourist who arrived in Phuket on July 18th. He sought treatment after developing fever, rashes, and blisters. Local health authorities believe the man was infected even before arriving in the country. Thailand's first case is a Nigerian man who also visited Phuket but refused treatment and went to Cambodia. The second patient is a 47-year-old Thai man. Dengue cases in the Calabarzon region have breached 8,000, with Antipolo City recording the highest number of patients. Michael Deliso joins us on the line for more details of that. Go ahead, Michael.
Yes, Ron, at least 283 additional dengue cases were recorded in the Calabarzon region in the last week of July, or from July 24th to 30th. According to the Department of Health, Center for Health Development in Calabarzon, the total number of cases this year is now 8,279, with 14 fatalities. This year's number of cases so far is 83% higher compared to the same period in 2021. Most cases were recorded in Laguna with 2,523, while there are over 1,000 cases in Rizal, Quezon, Cavite, Batangas, and 98 in Lucena City. Most affected age group is still 1 to 10 years old with 3,191 cases. In Cavite, most of the cases are in Imus City. Imus Mayor Alex Advincula said the increasing number of dengue cases is slowing down the local government's COVID-19 booster drive since public health workers are also busy caring for dengue patients. Fogging and misting operations are in full swing in Barangay San Isidro, Antipolo City in Rizal, where there are also some cases. Village officials are reminding residents to keep surroundings clean as one of the preventive measures against dengue. Antipolo is the top city in the region with most cases. Back to you, Ron.
Michael Deliso with that report. Thanks, Michael. A member of the Health Department's technical advisory group confident the country can handle the risks of COVID transmission when classes open later this month. Dr. Anna Ong Lim argues the country now has more knowledge on containing the virus. On monkeypox, however, she believes more should be done to educate the public on prevention and infection management.
The transmission dynamics of monkeypox is quite different from COVID. We're really quite blessed that it's not a respiratory virus, which would have made it much, much more difficult to deal with in the school setting. So since this is primarily skin-to-skin contact, and once again, we do expect symptoms to be present, if we follow, again, the minimum public health standards and we're vigilant about not reporting to school when we're feeling sick, this should be helpful, no, in preventing spread of this and other diseases.
The Philippine Health Department assures the public the country can manage possible monkeypox transmission following its detection here last week. Rafael Bosano reports.
The country is ready to manage our monkeypox cases. The country is ready to do surveillance for the monkeypox transmission.
This is what the Department of Health assures the public following the detection of the first case of monkeypox in the Philippines last week. Latest information from the DOH says all close contacts of the first monkeypox case remain asymptomatic. Aside from the virus, one of the greatest challenges faced by the public is misinformation and discrimination for those infected with the virus.
Gusto nating klaruhin, monkeypox has not been classified as a sexually transmitted disease. The very reason kung bakit naiisip siguro ng mga tao na ito ay STD ay dahil sa presentasyon na naipapakita niya. Nakita po natin that almost 95% of cases across the globe was transmitted through sexual contact.
The World Health Organization says anyone can get infected with monkeypox.
It's a virus. Viruses can affect anybody. Intimacy, the close contact, it doesn't have to be sexual contact, but that's really helped move this virus from person to person. If one person in the household becomes infected, it can be quite easy for that then to transmit to others in the same household, again through just the close physical contact that comes to, you know, with being in a close family. Nothing to do with sex.
Aside from usual symptoms like fever and swollen lymph nodes, The WHO says they are seeing new manifestations of illness.
This includes things that can be extremely painful and need medical care, such as secondary infections or such as inflammation or swelling of the rectum. These are really conditions that require care. But in addition, there can be the occasional condition such as encephalitis, which is inflammation of the brain.
In the Philippines, other agencies like the Department of Transportation is now planning to work with the DOH to come up with guidelines to avoid viral transmission, particularly in public transportation. This especially now that public utility vehicles operate at full capacity. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.